I've been a walking heartache. I've made a mess of me. The person that I've been lately ain't who I want to be. But you stay here right beside me and watch as a storm blows through. And I need you. 'Cause God gave you for the ups and downs. God gave you for the days.
Stand, please.
I would bet my life like I bet my heart that you were the one, baby. I've never been so sure of anything before. You're driving my heart crazy.
Gives this woman in marriage?
Her brother and I do.
But please remain standing for prayer. Dear God in heaven, Lord, we love you and thank you so much for this beautiful wedding, this beautiful day. And Lord, I know that what we do here is not near as important as what you do in heaven. Lord, I ask you even now, Lord, to just unite Colby and Shelby in a very special way. Lord, I pray that their home will be founded on you, that they'll love you and love each other all the days of their life. For we ask it all in God's precious holy name. Amen. You may be seated. Is that where you want to stand? Okay. Marriage is God's first institution for the race, originated in divine wisdom and happiness, designated to promote human happiness. This foundation was set forth by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It was authorized by and showed his first miracle at the wedding of Cana of Galilee. So it's ordained that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh, united in hopes and aims and sentiments. in all this present world. If you then, Colby and Shelby, have freely and deliberately chosen each other in the holy matrimony, and know of no just cause why you should not be so united, would you please join your right hands? Right hand, okay. Colby, in taking Shelby by the right hand to be your lawful wedded husband, you must promise to love her and cherish her, and leaving all others, cleave only to her, and be to her in all things a true and faithful husband, so long as you both shall live. Colby, do you promise? Shelby, in taking Colby by the hand, be your faithful and wedded husband before God and these witnesses present. You must promise to love him, to honor him, and cherish him in that relation. And leaving all others, cleave only unto him, and be to him in all things a faithful wife, so long as you both shall live. Do you so promise? Amen. Let's go over to the cross table. This is one of the most beautiful things that I've seen in a long time. It's my first time, so bear with me. And I know it's Shelby's and Kobe's first time, but I think it's a beautiful symbol for what's happening here tonight. At this time, Kobe and Shelby will assemble the Unity Cross, a beautiful sculpture that they will display in their home to remind them of this night forever. In Genesis 1, we read that God created man in his own image. That means that he created man bold and strong to be tender and be the loving protector of his wife. The outer cross that Colby's holding represents the strength, leadership, and protection of the man. The book of Ephesians reminds man that he is to love his wife as Christ loved the church, totally and completely giving himself for it. We can place that in the base. As well, Genesis also tells us that the woman was taken from man. The bride's piece of the Holy Cross represents the beauty, and that's certainly true tonight, because she is a beautiful bride, and the many capabilities that a woman has, designed in detail to be placed inside the protection of the groom's cross, completing the sculpture and representing two becoming one. To complete the sculpture, we have representing, we need three pegs. These pegs represent the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. At this time, they'll place them in there, binding the cross, the outer cross, to the inner cross. Colby, from this day forth, brother, it's going to be your responsibility to look after Shelby, to love her and honor her and cherish her in all that you do. And I'm going to expect you to do that. I'm going to expect you as a minister of the gospel to keep your vow that you've made tonight to look after her, protect her, and love her in all things. Shelby, I'm going to ask you to do something a little different. I'm going to ask you to encourage Colby. You know, I found that if a wife encourages her husband, he'd make it. Like when all the world's against him, he can come home, there's a precious wife there to say, "Hello, honey, how you doing?" And you help him. You be a helper to him. God didn't take the bone to make the wife out of his head to look over her or in his foot to step on her. He took it from his side that y'all might walk together forever and ever. Amen. Okay? You understand that, both of you. Okay, y'all follow me. I need the big ring. Colby, I want you to place this on Shelby's finger. I want you to look at her. Repeat after me, okay? Look at her.
With this ring,
I thee wed.
With loyal love,
I thee endow.
And
with all my worldly goods,
with thee
I share. In the name of the Father, and the Son,
and the Holy Spirit,
blessed forevermore. Amen. Colby, you just gave away your pickup.
I didn't have one. No worries.
Okay. Where's the other ring? Okay, Shelby, I want you to place this on Colby's finger and repeat after me.
With this ring,
I thee wed.
With loyal love,
I thee endow.
And all my worldly goods,
with thee I share.
In the name of the Father,
and the Son,
and the Holy Ghost,
blessed forevermore.
Amen.
You just gave away your car. It's not mine anymore, it's ours, okay? I want y'all to go through life like that. It's ours. It's ours. It's our blessing to share. It's our laugh to enjoy. Sometimes there's tears, but you try together. That's what makes a marriage a marriage. And I ask you to do this. Have God in your home. If you have the Lord in your home, Satan won't be there. If God's not there, he'll move in. And I'm going to ask you to ask God into your home. Ask God to bless you and help you in all that you do. For then as much as Colby and Shelby have come together according to the scriptures of this state, I, as a minister of the gospel, declare therefore that you are joined together as husband and wife. I'm going to pray. Dear God, I thank you for Colby and Shelby. I thank you for their families. I thank you, Lord, for their sweet spirit. And Lord, I ask you to bless them in a very special way. I thank you for their families. And I thank you, Lord, that you love us. And I ask you, Lord, to bless us and help us, for we ask in Jesus' name. Colby, you may kiss your brand new bride. I'd like to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Colby Ivy.
I was sitting with my friend when I saw you walking in, and my heart started skipping a beat. I was trying to play it cool, but I knew it was true that nobody would ever compete. Well, first comes love, and then comes first date, first kiss. We were checking off the list, and you were getting down on your knee. And you didn't have to guess, it was always a yes. Now there's two less fish in the sea. Let's set the date, let's hurry back. Something blue and the chairs lined up in the yard. The I-dos and the kisses from a miss to a missus. Can't wait for forever to start. Let's set the date, let's hire a band. Spinning from the booze and the last song's finally sung. We can run to the room, kick stop the honeymoon, gonna set